Yeah, share my screen, right? Please confirm my screen is visible or not. It's visible, right? Hello.
Yes, Kaushik, your screen is
Yes,
visible.
Okay. So today is the last day of our session, and two important topic that is left. One is deployment your production app application in production or development. Another is test case in React. How we can write the test case and we can execute the test case. So we'll start from the deployment part. Okay. So we can say that there is two kinds of routing we saw, the client side routing and the server side routing. So in React, it's a node based modules. So we can render our applications through Node.js. There is no, only base HTML5 is there, but inside that base HTML file, we are calling the other files. So, but when we deploy our code, after creating the code base, optimize our code, then build the production, okay? So that time we have to create some setups in our package.json file, and by default some setup is there and we can deploy. So ultimately what happened, actually the node modules, they are rendering through transpiler. One transpiler means compiler. Transpiler and compiler, both are present in the, when you convert your Node.js modules to React, your JavaScript book, okay? Because browser only understand the JavaScript code. So it renders with HTML5, CSS3, and JavaScript. And today I will show you that in the cloud, in the AWS, only one part, the how you can deploy your code. In the bucket, you have to add your bucket and you have to add your code base, and then it will run as it is run in the local server. So this is the process, simple process. There is no any complex, no any rocket science over there. We can writing our code base, we can test our code and optimize how much we can optimize the code that the performance should be better. So we, in the deployment step, there is some lazy loading effects. You can saw that how the all code base are rendered through lazy loading method. This is all coming in the, and the same thing, the React developer tools, it was previously discussed, right? So this is my one application, it's normal. After creating the boilerplate of the React, we can get this type of settings, like we got the files folder, like app.js, index.js, package.json. You can see some points, that script, right? This is the block. This is the objects where we can set start, build, test, and eject, four command. So you can add your and the, when we build the application, we run, we were writing that npm run build. So internally it calls React script build, okay? So instead of build, we can create our own script tag also, right? Build one or custom build. You can write custom build. First, we have to run the application. Simple, it's running normal code. And then instead of build command, I will run custom build this command. take some time for optimizing the application. You can see that React script build. So internally it calls this command, React script build. Okay, it takes some time. Now you can see, and the build is complete, and we can show one folder like build. So inside the build, only HTML and CSS files are there. You can see the media. When if I open this file, the build. So same thing, I have to upload in the server, right? So otherwise we cannot understand that the build is means same output we can expect. I'm localhost 3000 and the local server it's running. Now, same thing we can upload in the AWS server. It's a free tier application. So you can see the screen, right? AWS page, Amazon S3. So I only upload the code base because Amazon S3 itself is a storage, is a bucket where you can store something. Because in the React application, only this kind of these things only you can understand that S3 is a bucket, is a service where we can upload our code base, is a storage, anything we can store over there, the S3 bucket. Okay. So we can create one folder. You see, earlier I have uploaded this page, hello HTML. Now codebase demo I have to upload. Now you can see the simple upload screen. You can and click add a folder. Copy the path and then paste it. All files are uploaded in the cloud history bucket. Take it upload, it takes some time. Now close that. Index.html, open. Okay. The path is different. You can edit that. Some link is. Files but the properties it's working, but some cheese. Market yeah. Yes, the application is running. That time, I think the bucket access policy was not working, so that's all. You can see that this link you can also open in your browser. So we'll refresh this code and then remove it. Index.html. Try this code. See what happened. Yes, now you can try. I can also get access. I've shared in the chat. Everybody try that you can get the access or not. Please confirm. Rahul. Hello. Hello, Rahul. Hello.
Yes, hello, hello.
Have you tried this thing?
Yes,
Have you run?
open. It's loading, loading. Just give me a minute. Yes, run.
Run, right?
Yeah.
So your application is running from the browser. It's server, okay? Anywhere you can run this code. In React application, you can upload over there, okay? Same thing.
So in our projects is also using AWS.
No,
This
no,
one is
no, no.
example.
That's a different, different environment they can use.
Okay.
Anybody can use GCP. Anybody can use AWS. So as per the business, that can be decided. But I've shown that how your code should be deployed over there, right? This thing.
For the trial purpose, we can also use AWS, or this one is paid version like.
No, that AWS. You can also anywhere AWS, GCP, anywhere you can also upload your code base. Okay.
Okay.
So create any projects and then npm run build. After this, you can run the code. Okay.
Yeah.
So simple thing. The code is running. Same thing. Now, after deployment, first we have to show that test cases. How we can write the test case, right? This thing is pending. Deployment part is done. And you can remember this, you can add your custom command over there in the script tag. Now, a test case, I'm writing the test case. 1 minute. Case and so now for the test case, we have to install these three libraries. that testing library, JSON DOM, and the user event. This and the React, these three library we can use, and we add the dependencies and then run. After that, this is the installation step. The dependencies, we can install the library for the JSON DOM, React, and the user event. Okay. Now we have to write our first test case. So first we have to create one file. The name is setup_test.js. And for writing our TypeScript for the app.js, same name, we can create another file, but with the test. Again, set up our code. Have to import. This package app.js, have to import render and the screen from Yeah. Input our app from app. Writing the test case, we have to create one block, simple block, the test block, fast rendering block. Renders fast test case. This is a block. Multiple blocks we can create like this. This is the title of the test case. Which test case we are running in the browser in our code base. So this is the title. Now first we have to render our app. And then const one element screen object dot, you can get list of properties of this object, right? In my case, I use get by text. Add value is coming from here. Learn React. We are trying to establish a code. This text is present or not in the inside the code base, right? So we will add this things. Now, simple thing, we can expect something from the test case, right? So expect this element dot to be in the document. That means when the test is running, it will render the app, it will get all access from the app. After getting access, try to find out the text Learn React, which is present inside the application function in the text. Now, run our test case. How we can run our test case? So, we can again go package.json file. We can see the test. Same script command, this is the executable command, the React. In the script tag, we can get the test command. So my command would be this npm run test for testing the application, for testing app. In the test cases, let's see how it is work. Take the another comment window. CMD npm run test. We can observe that it will internally goes to the React script test. That means this file, this command. And it will go to that setup.js, setup test.js, where our JS DOM is bootstrapping. Application, the test library is bootstrapped over there, means initialize the JS DOM. Now you see it fails. To be in the document is not a function. Okay, let's see what happened.
I think only to be is there. I think
what
only to be.
No, not to be. I think block is okay. Tremendous block. Screen dot create by text. Type error. Document. Oh, this is the what are the mistake? strange. Maybe in the document is not a function. That Okay, now creates another file and to see that is go to the getting test.js file. This we have to write same import the screen. Test. click on variable. Not add if that false here and expect right, let's see two test case. Same thing. No, sorry. Some problem in the to be in document, but let's see 1 minute. Library have taken wrong. Okay. Is there any other 2Bs there? I think this command not understood by that setup test. Maybe some problem. Thank you. No problem is there. No, test case is pass. Actually, some flag I have to set and this flag detect open handles. Now you see that test case is running successfully. So that is all for my side. Is there any questions? Any queries you can ask me? Hello.
Hello. No, no.
Yes.
It's clear.
You means today's session you understood, right? It means test case and deployment. How it is going on. So, Sweta, I just stop my presentation, right? Hello.